Rafah, and that was a pre-population of 150,000. You know, so I think just kind of thinking of that ratio is, we found ourselves, we're not the only actor, but we have...
How many Red Cross volunteers, employees do you actually have who are vulnerable to the bombing and the vice versa?
So, I mean, for us, we don't have any British Red Cross staff who are deployed or...
Pascal, good morning or good afternoon, and thank you for joining us. I'm sorry to hold you up. I just wanted to hear a little bit about what's going on out there, Pascal, and how you're all coping.
I have to admit that what I see here is really, I don't even have words anymore to describe what we're seeing, what we are hearing. I'm doing that job for the last 30 years. I'm head of delegation for the RCRC for more than 20 years. I was the head of delegation in Ukraine last year, and in many of the crises, I was in Afghanistan, Syria. And this is, you know, something that is, I think, unprecedented. With a health system that is totally collapsed. And you know, a hospital needs not only to be protected as a structure, but if there is not there, if you have any question, please.
Thank you, Pascal. Pascal, how are you keeping spirits up in your organization? How are you keeping people motivated to deliver the support and the humanitarian work you're doing in such conditions?
Because you mentioned alone, you know, we are a bit powerless, you know, in such an environment.